here at the friendly confines, Wrigley Field. MLB The Show has interleague action for you this afternoon. It's the Chicago White Sox and the Chicago Cubs. First pitch coming your way next. So, almost ready to get underway, getting the nod on the mound, it'll be Marcus Stroman.
It's always interesting to see how he utilizes all of his pitches and how many of those he has a good feel for on that given day. When he's right, he's really able to keep hitters guessing, and all of his stuff seems to be coming out of the same arm slot, the same tunnel, and that can make life very difficult on his opponents.
Here's Tim Anderson. The why to kick the pitch. That misses the zone, and we are underway. Here comes a pitch. And a foul ball. Kicks and deals.
Well, 2-1.
Foul ball.
Also really good at bat. What I like about this guy, his bat stays in the zone for a long time. Gives him the ability to foul off tough pitches.
Oh, that got him. First batter of the game is hit by the pitch. So a substitution needed at first because of the injury. And here's the pinch runner, Elvis Andrus. Luis Robert now. Worm burner into the outfield for a knock. Lead runner holds up. They're at first and second with nobody out.
Well, that started and ended pretty quickly. No messing around right there. Pretty tough for the infielders to do anything with that one. He pulled it hard into the outfield, and even when you keep it on the ground, it feels great when you hit a missile like that.
First and second, no outs. Now, Andrew Benintendi. In there, and it's 0-1. Andrus at second. Robert on at first with nobody out.
Let's stop the right here.
Next pitch is popped up. No trouble here. Puts it away for the out. And there's one down. Time to check out the lineup for the White Sox. They're dealing with a sinker specialist on the mound, which can be a big-time challenge when he's right and working mostly from the knees down.
Well, I think the approach you take is really try to lay off of those pitches down in the zone until he gets some called strikes and then forces you to go after that pitch. Until then,
runners on the move. Swing and a miss. The throw, tag, and he's out. Next one misses, and now it's even 1-1. One of the coolest moments of Marcus Stroman's career, Chris, He was the MVP of the 2017 World Baseball Classic. Team USA won gold. He took a no-hitter into the seventh inning of the championship game. The next offering misses. 2-1.
Really so awesome to see how guys buy into the WBC in spring training. They really take it seriously once they put on that USA uniform.
Hard ground ball, base knock. Robert on his way around third. He scores, and it's 1-0.
Well, they strike first as he gets the job done to bring home the run. Everyone's trying to elevate the ball in today's game, but if you can hit a ball that hard on the ground, it's going to find some holes.
Yoan Moncada with a chance to hit. That one's in there, 0-1. Stroman, a former Gold Glove winner, he features a sinker, a slider, a splitter, a cutter, and he works in a four-seamer. Next pitch downstairs, and the count is 1-1. In the dirt, but kept close. Throw to second, not in time. He's there easily. And the righty deals. That one down the line, and that's just foul. Swing and a miss, and that is that. One run, a pair of hits, no errors, and one left on. Eloy Jimenez helps out the Pale Hoes with this big swing. It's an early 1-0 lead. Major League Baseball is on the show. Back here at the friendly confines. And on the mound today, a guy who will give them innings, Dylan Cease.
Very solid starters, able to repeat his mechanics on a consistent basis, which allows him to move through a lineup and get deep into a ball game.
Now into the game, Elvis Andrews. He's in at shortstop. Now here's Nico Horner. He's kind of an outlier, especially when guys are consciously sacrificing contact to deliver power. And the first offering is not close.
Yeah, his swing is so good. It's in the zone a long time. He gets the barrel to it a lot, and that produces more base hits.
And a pitch. He swings and fouls one off. Next offering is in for a strike. Singy, one of the things that's interesting is that guys really don't worry about swing and miss from an offensive standpoint anymore. So when you see somebody who contacts the ball like this, do you think of that as plus value?
Absolutely. If he's doing damage now, if he's rolling over and grounding out, then it's a different story. But yeah, if he can put the ball in the gaps or over the fence, 100%.
The wind of the pitch. Popped up, foul territory behind the plate. Grandal makes the catch, and there's one away. Here's a look at the Cubs lineup. They're already down a run, so I'm sure they'd like to punch back and even things up early.
Yeah, it's never a good feeling, especially at your home ballpark, to go down in the first inning. So the best way is just to come out aggressive, try to tie the ball game up, but not just tie it up. Take the lead. I tell you what, momentum can really swing, and you can put your pitcher back in a position where he feels his most confident.
To the left side, but it is well foul. Kicks and fires. Check swing, he held up, and it's a ball and a strike. Nice warm day here, good baseball weather. Does that change anything, Chris, especially for the hitters?
Absolutely. You feel so much more comfortable at the plate. You're not worried about, you know, getting jammed on fastballs inside part of the plate. You can kind of be more selective instead of just looking out away so that you can get the barrel to it in that part. You can get it on the inside part of the plate as well.
Got it by him for the K.
Well, that's always the key to effective pitching, is getting ahead in the count. And as a pitcher, it really allows you to start expanding the zone. Guys become defensive, and all of a sudden, for the hitter, that plate starts to get really wide. And what happens is, because of the pressure, you end up committing to a pitch as a batter before you recognize what it is, and that's what leads to the strikeout.
Comes up empty on the swing, 0-2 now.
It's interesting. You have spring training, wonderful weather, and then most teams go north and it's chilly. So hitters have to kind of get through that for the first month and a half, and then everything evens out.
Two down, nobody on. Just off the inside edge. How much did your dress change when it would get cold, or when it would be cold early or late in the season?
Well, early in the season, Boog, I'm taking
it. And it stays fair. Makes the turn and heads for second. And the double puts the tying run in scoring position with two away.
Gotta love the resiliency he showed in that at bat, battling with two strikes. There's something about pulling one down the line and shooting it through the infield that's just so satisfying as a hitter. It's just fun turning on a pitch like he did right there.
Man at second here with two away. Now the Cubs four-hole hitter, Seiya Suzuki. First offering, and it just misses. The 1-0. Good eye right there.
And the strategy of winning a ball game, when you can make that pitcher work a little more, expose himself by throwing pitches, that could be the key to winning perhaps later on. So good job of extending this inning, getting a knock with two outs to bring the number four hole hitter up. One way to make a guy real uncomfortable at the plate is pound him inside with good velocity. They're doing that right here.
That one in for a strike, 2-2.
Well, he's realizing out there on the mound that he's got to settle in pretty quickly, or else he's going to get hit hard in this first inning.
Man on second, two down. Still 2-2 after the foul ball. Man at second. Foul ball, another 2-2 upcoming. And that misses off the outside edge.
The only adjustment he needs to make is his target. If you aim at the outside corner, that slider's going to end up way off the plate. Perhaps look a little more down the middle, and you get it right where you want it.
And that one is lifted in the air. Sheets under it. He's got it, and that'll end the inning. Cubs leave one, still behind by a count of 1-0. Back here at Wrigley Field, Andrew Vaughn now.
The first baseman is number 25, Andrew Vaughn.
And a pitch. And a strike. Slider clips the zone.
Man, this guy's got a great feel for his breaking ball today.
Clyde Washington with home plate duties in this one.
A little bit of a low zone, Boog, from Clyde. Nothing crazy, though. Pitchers that work consistently down around the knees and are able to command their off-speed stuff tend to have some pretty good success with him back there behind the plate.
And the 0-2. Knocks that one away, and we'll do it again. The wind and the pitch. Check swing, tried to hold up, now an appeal to first. And Ed Drummond right on it, says he held up. And a ball and two strikes. Stays alive. The wind of the pitch. Swing and a ground ball out to short. Over to Hosmer. And quickly one away in the second.
Batting seven. The catcher.
Yasmani Grandal up to hit. The outfield shifted pretty heavily towards right field. Next offering is down low, and it's 1-0. Just missed. Righty delivers. And that one wrapped foul. One down, base is empty. And a big swing and a miss. And now 2-2. Caught it, looking for the K.
That'll just ripped a page out of the Greg Maddux playbook. Throw that pitch at the hip and just watch it jump back over the inside part of the plate. Tell you what, you are baffled expecting that to almost hit you and then end up as a called strike.
Wisdom makes the catch, and that'll do it. Nothing doing for the White Sox, but they lead it 1-0. Back here at the ballpark, leading here's Hosmer.
The first baseman, Aaron Hosmer.
And the pitch. Just missed.
That's a really good take right there. Slider down and in. Very difficult to get on the same plane and do anything with.
And that one fouled off. Swing and a miss. And a count 1-2. That one missed. Next pitch is in the dirt. Counts full, 3-2. The 3-2 is off the outside edge, and that is ball four.
Man, that's a tough one to take on the full count, but I guess he saw it really well. It's a really nice plate appearance.
No outs, runner at first. And now here's the veteran DH, Trey Mancini. In there for strike one. The pitch. And there's a ball. Hosmer gets his lead at first. Nobody out. Cuts and misses. It's a strikeout.
Oh, that's a curveball that I'm sure he wants back at the plate. Two strikes, the sort of pitch you're hoping for. A bit of a mistake, and I'd say in a very hittable location, but clearly the break was enough to get him to swing through it.
One down. Here comes Cody Bellinger. First pitch, and that's in for a strike.
Cody Bellinger, no stranger to the big stage. He played in the 2007 Little League World Series. He's the 14th player ever to play in both the Little League World Series and the Major League World Series.
Next offering is foul back. Oh, and two now. Foul off the plate. They'll do it again. The pitch.
Good miss with that changeup away. He needs a ball on the ground for a double play. Minimize the potential threat right here. On the hitter side, nice job of laying off that pitch.
Next offering misses, and the count's even at two. And that's downstairs and outside.
Well, with the amount of pitches that can end up in the dirt, a good secondary lead doesn't have to get away from the...
And down on strikes he goes, and there's two away.
Committed to that breaking ball just a little too much and couldn't pull the bat back in time. Well, once you get it going, it can be so tough to stop the momentum of that barrel. Good pitch, had him fooled.
And now, Patrick Wisdom. He swings and misses at the first pitch, 0-1. At the belt and fires. Ball one there. Singy Wisdom's a guy with big time power. 2021, he broke the Cubs rookie record for homers in a season as he surpassed Chris Bryant's total of 26. He came up with 28 home runs. And here it comes. That one blasted deep to right, way back there. That's down, one hops off the wall. Coming home, and the tying runs at second base with a double. The tying run comes around from first. It's 1-1.
Gets it done to drive in the run and tie it back up. When you connect and it jumps off your bat like that, you're thinking double at the very least. What a great swing on it, and man, he wasn't fooled at all.
And now the batter is Tucker Barnhart. In there, and it's 0-1. Tied up here in the early going. Two as he waves at that one.
All you got to do is concentrate and execute this next pitch. Get yourself out of the jam, back into the dugout.
Got him. Good job at damage control right there.
He's in a tough spot, had to make a great pitch, did it, got the strikeout, gets out of the jam. Clearly, he's happy with those results.
On the north side of Chicago, John Ciambi and Chris Singleton. New inning getting started. And now it's going to be Leury Garcia. The right-hander back to work. And that one hit to first. And he takes it himself for the out. Here's Elvis Andrus. Came into the game as a pinch runner, This is his first trip to the plate in this one. Andrews getting to start at shortstop, hitting leadoff in today's game. He joined the team as a free agent. And the first pitch misses for ball one. And a swing and a miss.
The baseball is coming out of his hand very well. He's been able to paint all four corners, but really good ride at the top of the zone. Hitters have to respect that. Very difficult pitch to hit.
But you want. Andrews checks his swing. Now an appeal to first. And that's a swing, according to umpire Ed Drummond. The 2-2. This ball's chopped on the ground, and he grabs it in foul ground. Righty to the plate. Keeps the at-bat going with a foul ball. And he deals. Line and a base hit into right.
Just one of those at-bats you almost hate to see come to an end. Pretty much a model swing on that one as he ripped it into the opposite field gap. And I'm sure he's going to be watching that one back on video, because that's the kind of swing you want to bottle. So many positives that led to that knock.
Runner on at first with one gone. And now it's Luis Robert. First pitch doesn't find the zone. Robert measures 6 feet, 2 inches, 220 pounds, and he was born in Cuba. The pitch just off the outside edge.
Outside of the United States, Cuba has more players and representatives in Cooperstown than any other country. Puerto Rico and the Dominican Republic are close behind.
Andrews goes. That one fouled off, 2-2. Gets a piece there. We'll do it again. Andrews over at first with one away. The next pitch misses. 3-2 now. Right-hander kicks, deals, and there's ball four.
Well, that's a nice job of grinding out that at-bat. Saw a lot of pitches and ends up drawing the walk. Very gritty.
One down. Benintendi to the plate. He popped out his first time. First offering misses the mark. One out. Runners at first and second. Left field. Pat puts it away. And there's two away.
Yeah, that was a wasted RBI opportunity. But competitor like him, he is looking forward to making up for it in his next at-bat.
Here's Eloy Jimenez. Singled and drove in a run his first time through. And that's in there for strike one.
Is there a little wrinkle to that? I think there was.
Yeah. Little slider action.
Here's a swing and a drive left field, and he knew it. Eloy Jimenez leaves the yard, and just like that, they're out front. It's 4-1. He absolutely crushed that one.
No doubt about that one, Boone. We knew it wasn't coming back. A good hitter gets pitch recognition early. He saw exactly where that was going to be. The challenge, not get over anxious and come out of your swing. He stayed on it and got all of it.
Base is empty with two away. And now Yoan Moncada. And the first pitch misses for ball one. And another ball. The 2-0 is in for a strike. And the right-hander deals. Fouls one off. 2-2. The pitch. Line drive, base hit.
Back-to-back base hits. Nice line drive to the pole side. Met it out front, but just stayed through it nice enough and ripped it into the outfield.
Man at first. Next to hit, Andrew Vaughn. He's 0-1. That one's in there, 0-1. Kicks and deals. And ball one.
He's been trying to tease the zone with that slider, but these hitters have showed patience, not going outside the strike zone.
Line drive, and now maybe extra bases. Moncada, round second on his way to third. Moncada coming home, and he's got a double. In to score from first, and they lead by four.
That's now three hits in a row for the offense. I'll tell you, man, it's such a good feeling when you smoke a line drive into the gap like that. I mean, sure, home runs are king, but I feel like nothing makes you feel like a true professional hitter more than a bolt the other way.
And now up to the plate, Yasmani Grandal. Caught looking his first time up. First offering way inside, almost got him.
Well, a really rough inning out there on the mound. And this is one of those where you learn a lot about a guy's toughness and his ability to turn the page and keep pressing forward.
And there's the strike.
Good late sink on that fastball. Out of the hand, looks so good. And then by the time he gets in the hitting zone, hard to get the barrel to it.
Runner leads away at second. Way high.
Clearly, he hasn't had it in this game. And looks like sooner than later, they're going to have to go to the bullpen.
Next offering way off the plate. Grandal tries to check his swing. Now a look to third. No swing. Earl Hendricks with the call.
Well, he earned his trip to first right there. It's not easy laying off pitches that just missed the zone like that. And it's a real discipline as well. He's put a lot of work into that aspect of his game, and it paid off right there.
Hard out, baby. ripped to third. It's in and out of his glove. He doesn't have a throw, and he reaches safely.
First pitch swing in, went up there with the plan to be aggressive. Really good swing right there. He got a pitch that he knew he could handle, allowed himself to stay back just a tad bit longer, and he hit the ball on the screws.
Leury Garcia up to the plate.
And a foul ball.
Well, they've been able to score four runs off of him in this inning, and this is where you want to just max out. Get as much as you can. Give him one of those tough innings where it's going to be hard for him to recover in the next one.
Swing and a ball lifted left field. Makes the grab, and that's the inning. So they move out in front after a four-run outburst. We head down to the home half of inning number three. It's the White Sox 5 and the Cubs 1. Welcome back. Here's the second baseman, Nico Horner.
He's not the power guy, but he can hurt you to all parts of the ballpark.
Cease back to work. High fly ball out into left center field. Benintendi makes the grab. One pitch and one out.
The batter number seven. Shortstop.
Dansby Swanson stands in. Went down on strikes his first time through.
Swanson, former first round pick by the Arizona Diamondbacks. Vanderbilt player in college, College World Series player, all that good stuff, but really coming into his own.
Line drive, and that should be extra bases. Around first and hustling for second. Not stopping, he's going for three. The relay to third, the tag out.
The triple is arguably the most exciting play in baseball, and a guy's worked so hard to get around first, to get around second, and to get thrown out at third. Man, you just feel bad for him. On top of that, he was already in scoring position, so you think about how it kind of hurts the team as well.
Ian Happ up to hit. First pitch doesn't find the zone. That clips the inside corner for a strike.
Happ, a switch hitter. It can be challenging for guys at the big league level to maintain a good swing from both sides of the plate. Clearly, he's got more pop from the left side, but in 2022, the right side was respectable as well.
Here comes a pitch. Fouls it off, still one and two. The wide to kick the pitch. Got him looking. And good work there as he gets a 1-2-3. Three up, three down for the Cubs. They're down here 5-1. And welcome back. And the batter will be the shortstop, Elvis Andrus.
Elvis Andrus.
And a pitch. There's a strike. Just missed. Here's a 1-1. Fought off foul. And the righty deals. Gets a piece and stays alive. The wind of the pitch. And the 1-2 misses to even the count. Way outside, full count 3-2. Up the middle, Swanson picks it up. Just got him on that one.
I love how guys at this level are able to slow the game down, whether it's in the batter's box or on defense. And right there, that was a good job of knowing just how much time he had. We talk about that internal clock. He was able to gather himself, get a good grip, and make an accurate throw across the diamond.
Here's the center fielder, Luis Robert. First offering misses badly for ball one. And that gets the inside corner for a strike. Back to the mound. Nice grab. Not in time. He legs it out.
A fun play right there, Boog. He lays all the way out, makes the stop, but just wasn't able to get it there in time. And, of course, there's the hustle out of the box as well to earn the infield single. Just a great baseball play.
Andrew Benintendi steps up. Bounce to the right side. Steps on first for the out.
Now batting, the designated hitter, Eloy Jimenez.
Eloy Jimenez now. He's already homered in this game. Here's a high fly ball out to center. Bellinger drifts towards it. That is the inning. So a man left for the White Sox. They lead this one, though, 5-1. Back here at the friendly confines. Now here is Seiya Suzuki.
Seiya Suzuki.
And the pitch. And ball one to the right fielder. And now 2-0 as that one missed below the knees. The wind and the pitch. There's a strike.
Generally, second, third time through the lineup, you want to be able to lean on those secondary pitches and command them. Looks like he's doing a nice job of it.
Next pitch is outside.
Well, these guys have had a hard time scoring in this one. The guy out there on the mound wants to keep attacking, make sure that they don't get any confidence.
The 3-1 in for a strike, full count. He goes down looking.
Now
it's Eric Hosmer. A walk and a run scored his first time. First offering and it just misses. And a pitch. And there's a foul ball. Left-hand batter waits. And now two balls and a strike.
2-1.
Started to go after it. Now a look down to third. Nope, he held back. The 3-1. Breaking ball through there for a strike.
3-1 count. Saying to himself, I've got to get a fastball here. Just spins a get me over breaking ball to bring the count full.
Swings through it for the K. The high heat, too much on that one. Back-to-back strikeouts to start the frame, and that's now 3 in a row.
Yeah, he's really settling in and getting a feel for his pitches, throwing them where he wants to right now. So we'll see how long he can keep this streak going.
Mancini stands in now, looks at that one inside. Ground ball up the middle. Tosses to first. That's the inning. Nothing happening there for the Cubs. They're down 5-1. We're back, and there's a new arm on the mound to start the fifth. Advert Alzola.
Number 73. Advert Alzola.
Here is Moncada, one for two.
The third baseman, Yoan Moncada.
And here it comes. And that one fouled off. Right-handed reliever. And that one missing low. Swing and a miss as he was late that time. One, two now. And now two and two. Spoils that one, and it remains two and two. The pitch.
Okay.
Good plate appearance there. Able to take the walk.
Well, he tried to nibble right there and just missed his spot. Hitter didn't offer at it. Now he has somebody to worry about over at first.
And here is Andrew Vaughn. In there for strike one.
Looks like he sacrificed to pitch right down the middle for tracking and timing. Some good hitters will do that.
0-1 down. They tried to get him to chase on a slider down and away. Moncada gets his lead at first with nobody out. Next offering is downstairs.
Back-to-back breaking pitches away, you get the feeling as a hitter that the pitcher's afraid of you, that he doesn't want to challenge you. So I think the confidence level is raised right here.
And fouled off. The pitch. That's down and in. And that's ball four.
You get a walk, and you get a walk. Everyone gets a walk, boo.
And next to hit for the Sox, Yasmani Grandal. He's 0 for 1.
Not the easiest thing when you're talking about a guy that's, you know, perhaps is going to be in the rotation, you know, maybe a long relief guy, to not start an inning, to come into an inning with pressure on it and try to get yourself comfortable.
Next offering upstairs.
Two walks in the inning already, and he just doesn't seem comfortable out there, like he can find the right mechanics and then repeat them.
Next one misses. Two balls and a strike.
Tough spot right here. A couple runners on. Two ball count. You can't nibble, but you have to execute and finish your pitch. If you leave something out over the plate, it's going to bring in some runs.
No outs. Runners at first and second. Righty delivers. Spoils the two-strike pitch, and he'll see another. Kicks and fires. Swing and a high fly ball down the right field line. Suzuki makes the catch. Runner tags up for third, and he moves up 90 feet. Runners at the corners now. One away.
Maybe caught that one off the end just a little bit. Couldn't quite barrel it up enough to really drive it.
And now the right fielder, Gavin Sheets. First offering misses the mark.
In this situation, the batter's got to know what the pitcher's trying to do to him, and that's trying to get him to hit the ball on the ground, get two for one. You got to look for something up in the zone, and worst case scenario, you deliver the sacrifice fly.
Tap to first, and he picks it up in foul territory. Two on, one out. Cracks his bat and pops him up. Swanson settles under it and makes the catch. Out number two.
Now that second baseman, Leury Garcia.
And next to hit for the Sox, Leury Garcia. In there, and it's 0-1. Late on that fastball.
He finds himself in a tough situation early. Just going to try to simplify it. Take a knock the other way if you can.
Two outs. Oh, and he hit him. He had two strikes on him, and he hit him.
Fastball high and tight right there. A scary combo. I'll tell you what, everyone in the stadium looked like they felt like they needed to jump out of the way. I know I moved.
Andrews in the box now. Takes strike one.
Tough situation right here. So important as a pitcher to get ahead in the count as he did right there.
Two outs. Bases are full. And he deals. Hacks and misses. It's a strikeout. And the White Sox will strand three. They're up 5-1. Here at Wrigley Field, John Schaube with my buddy Chris Singleton. It's set to get us started. Bottom five, Cody Bellinger. The right-hander back to work. Yeah, the pitch is in for a strike. That's strike one. In 2019, Cody Bellinger became the first Dodger player ever to collect the MVP, the Gold Glove. Oh, this one high and deep. Way back there. That one is gone. Cody Bellinger blasts one out, and they inch closer. It's 5-2.
Jet stream on a line drive. We saw the numbers on the backs of the jerseys of the outfielders, which is usually bad news, and all of a sudden they're back in this ball game.
Now here is Patrick Wisdom, doubled his first time up. And the first pitch misses for ball one.
Always exciting to see a leadoff home run in an inning. Kind of gets the offense fired up, and you start to expect a big inning.
And the 1-0.
And the slider just misses.
Looks like he's being a little cautious with him in this at bat after doubling the first time up. Doesn't want to make another mistake.
Next pitch misses. Three balls, no strikes. Right-hander kicks, deals. And the slider catches the zone.
This doesn't seem to want to throw him a fastball.
The wind of the pitch. Out towards right center field. Sheets makes the catch. One down.
Up next is the Cubs.
Tucker Barnhart, the next Cub to hit.
Barnhart.
First pitch, and he has to get out of the way.
Straighten him up a little bit.
Next offering is in for a strike. Slider misses outside. Next offering is down low. Three-one, and he couldn't come up with it.
It feels to me like his time on the mound is running short, starting to show some signs of fatigue. So we'll see how much longer they let him go.
So up next, Nico Hoerner. Good contact guy, good defender. Chris, baseball today, so many strikeouts, and they are available to pitchers. But this is a guy that puts the bat on the ball and is kind of different from the players that we see day in, day out. First pitch, not close. Next offering misses, and that's ball two. And the pitch. Right side. Can't glove it cleanly. To first, and he beats it. Everyone's safe. Dansby Swanson, the next Cub to hit. A guy who makes an impact not just at the plate, but also in the field. First pitch doesn't find the zone. In the dirt. Well done behind the dish. Action in the pen down there. Ronaldo Lopez up and loosening in the pen. Ruiz getting loose as well. Runners at first and second with one gone. There's a strike.
Well, he came right at him right there. Challenged him with the 2-0 fastball. Not sure exactly what he was looking for, but gotta imagine that's a confidence booster on the mound. You're in that hitter's head a little bit.
Next pitch inside, and now 3-1. Battling here as he fouls it away. And a 3-2. Fights it off. He'll see another.
Pretty good pitch there to take a rip at. He wants to get his arms extended. He likes the ball away from him a little bit, just not able to square it up.
3-2. The 3-2 is off the outside edge, and that is ball four.
Now that sets up a really big at bat in this game. These are the moments when everyone in the stadium gets really locked in.
So digging in, Ian Happ. First offering misses the mark.
Part of the order coming through now, and with one home run already in this inning, they're definitely looking to do some more damage.
Barnhart at third, Horner over at second, Swanson over at first with one away.
Well, you can't really adjust your game plan for that last pitch. Guy hasn't thrown it very much. You got to focus on the stuff that he's throwing up there most of the time.
Evens the count. The pitch. Next offering misses down and away.
Way to lay off that pitch down.
Struck him out looking. Called strike three and a fastball up in the zone.
Frustrating end to the at bat for the hitter, and I'm sure that's going to sit on him for a little while. You want to be ready to hit the fastball. Sometimes you can overthink things, and I think that was the case right there.
And next for the Cubs, Seiya Suzuki. And he swings and misses, and it's nothing and one. Pitch that misses and one and one. That one missed.
Look, in situations like these, the air can get really thin up there at the plate. Got to find a way to breathe and slow everything down.
Next pitch is outside. Bases loaded, two down. Ball four, and a run comes in to score.
Really got himself into a mess out there, and now forces home a run with the wall. This inning's definitely getting away from him.
Now it's Eric Hosmer, a strikeout and a walk. And there's no doubt that they'll feed off the energy from this crowd, right?
I mean, yeah, I'd say the intensity level has gone up a few notches for sure.
First pitch, and he just misses. Can't find it here. That's six straight balls. The 2-0 is in for a strike. So the tying run at second. That one the other way. Brings it in for the third out. So they get two runs on two hits. One of them left the yard. We're through five. It's the White Sox five and the Cubs three.
The north side of Chicago, John Ciambi and Chris Singleton. Now the number two hitter, Luis Robert. Alzolay back to work. And that's outside. The Cubs bullpen with some action. Keegan Thompson throwing and getting ready for David Ross. Wick getting cranked up as well. Hit weakly on the ground. Over to Hosmer. One up, one down.
Deceptive slider right there. Stayed in the tunnel a long time. Got that hitter out front. Rolled over it. Put it on the ground.
Benintendi up here. When you look at Benintendi, think about this. He played in the same conference as both Alex Bregman and Dansby Swanson. Those two guys picked ahead of him in the first round. But it was Benintendi who was the SEC Player of the Year the year they all got drafted.
Yeah, the organization clearly saw something special in this kid as a prospect, and it's paid off nicely.
Next offering is in for a strike. Now, when you think about players in the past or even in today's game, who's a comparison?
He reminds me a little bit of Harold Baines. Both of them lefties, both outfielders, and he's shown similar types of production at the plate.
Two balls and a strike. Here it comes. Ripped on a line. No trouble here. Puts it away for the out. Two down. Here's the cleanup hitter for the Sox. Eloy Jimenez looking to do more of what he did back in the third.
No doubt. That three-run homer is a huge reason why they're in a good spot right now in this ball game. An important swing of the bat.
Smoked on the ground a second. Horner over to first. And they take care of Jimenez for the out. And that's the third out. Down in order go the White Sox. And it remains 5-3. Ronaldo Lopez gets handed the rock out of the pen.
And this is an important part of this game. Tight score and still a lot of outs to get. So they're looking for a big outing out of him right here to get some critical outs.
Trey Mancini now. Lopez, 29 years old, and he was born in the Dominican Republic. And a pitch. See the velocity, 97 with that fastball. Activity in the pen for the White Sox. Jake Diekman, the left-hander, is getting that big fastball of his ready to go. The pitch. Foul back our way, and that's out of play. Righty to the plate.
Two and one.
And he hits a ground ball right side and foul ball.
Where do you even begin with the talent we've seen from the Dominican Republic? Vladdy, Big Papi, Pedro, the list goes on and on.
Next offering upstairs. Yeah, the right-hander deals. Foul ball, and it remains a full count. And a pitch. Good job to fight that one off. And a payoff pitch. That one misses. So a leadoff walk.
What a battle. It's not always easy laying off a 3-2 pitch. And I tell you what, he earned that walk.
Here's Cody Bellinger. He's already homered here in this one.
Now this guy's definitely looking for a big swing of the bat right here. Try to close that gap. But, you know, at the very least, if you could find a way to manufacture that run from first, it feels like it's really important to getting back into this ballgame.
Left-hand hitter waits. And it's even up. Tying run at the plate. So a foul ball makes it 1-2. And the righty deals. Swings and misses, struck him out.
Well, you see him trying to pull that inside pitch right there, and that's not the kind of approach that you want to have. Even if you do get to it, it's going to be very difficult to keep it fair. You're just going to make it a long strike at best. You have to be able to stay within the baseball on the inside of that path to it, and that way, if you're a little quick, the ball gets hit hard somewhere, and it's not foul.
At the plate, Patrick Wisdom. And the first pitch misses for ball one. Mancini, the runner at first, with one gone in the inning. And it's 1-1. In the air, right field. Sheets has a beat on it. Drops into the glove. Two away. Tucker Barnhart, the next Cub to hit. Barnhart, in his ninth season, 32 years old, and he's a former Gold Glove Award winner. First pitch doesn't find the zone. Righty delivers. There's a strike. And delivers outside.
Two balls, one strike.
Lifted in the air, right field. And he'll play it on a bounce. Throw stops the lead runner at second. Two on and two out. So the batting order turns over. And the batter now, Nico Hoerner. Going one. And that one upstairs. The next offering misses, and that's ball two. Inside, just missed. Two outs, a couple of base runners at first and second. Swings and misses, and we're filled up. Swing and a miss, struck him out. He swung over top of the curveball. Cubs strand a couple. Still a two-run deficit. It's 5-3. We go to the top of the seventh, and now it's switch hitting third baseman, Yoan Moncada. Yeah, the right-hander back to work. And there's a ball. It's
So two balls and no strikes.
Boog, he never moved because he never had time to. But that kind of velocity, you'd prefer that pitcher work away.
Kicks and deals. That's in there. And he grounds one to the right side. Throws to first. And the leadoff hitter set down to open the seventh.
The first baseman is number 25, Andrew.
And now the first baseman, Andrew Vaughn. That one to first. And he handles it himself for the out.
The batter, the catcher, Yasmani Grandal.
Two outs, base is empty. Here's the catcher, Yasmani Grandal. First offering misses the mark. And here comes. Good eye right there. On the ground to first. Oh, can't pick it up cleanly, but in time. Nice job to stay with it to end the inning. So they go quietly there. Midway in inning number 7, and it's time to stretch. It's the White Sox 5 and the Cubs 3. We're back in a new pitcher here to start the bottom of the 7th. Jose Ruiz.
These are the spots relievers really make a name for themselves. Late and close. There's not much margin for error, but at the same time, there's a reason they're put in these situations.
Now it's the shortstop, Dansby Swanson.
The shortstop, Dansby Swanson.
The pitch. That's inside.
So important for him to control the heart rate right now. He's got to go through the heart of this lineup.
The pitch. That one finds the zone, and it's 1-2. This one in the air, right field. And that one gets down, fair ball. In safely with a double, his second of the day.
Man, those are the types of hits where you don't feel any vibration in your hands whatsoever. Such a good feeling. A lot of times in today's game, right fielders are able to get to a ball that stays in like that, but he hit that one pretty well. And if he hits it just a little bit different on the barrel, it's out of here easily. But there's nothing wrong with the extra bases right there. And you can feel this crowd waking up a bit here as the guys are starting to make some noise with their bats.
Runner in scoring position, no outs. Digging in is the switch inning outfielder, Ian Happ. First pitch, and he just misses. Swanson leads off second with nobody out. The next pitch misses, and now 2-0. Hit. Runner around third on his way to the plate.
He will score, and it's a one-run game. Safe at second with nobody out, and he represents the tying run.
Well, he gets it done in a big spot to get the run across. A solid swing from start to end, on time with everything, really good balance, nice extension, and he met it out front for the line drive knock. Now a huge at bat in this game coming up.
So now it's the Cubs hitter in the four hole, Seiya Suzuki. First pitch, and that's in for a strike. No outs, runner on second. They say it went. Man at second. Swing and a miss. Had him out front for the strikeout.
He came out of his mechanics there. Typically likes to shoot the ball the other way. But that time, a little anxious.
Jake Diekman comes on now.
And they felt it was time to bring on a left-handed reliever from the pen with the lefty hitter coming up. I think it's a good move. I know I never liked when opposing teams did that to me.
And next for the Cubs, Eric Hosmer. First offering, and it just misses. And another ball.
Well, this is a little tough for the hitter in the back of the mind. You're wondering, with first base open, am I going to get a pitch to hit? Got to stay back. Let your hands work. Stay in the middle of the field.
Hauls it in for the out. Throw to second, and they got him. Double play. Cubs pick up a run on the RBI double. It's down to one at 5-4. You're watching Major League Baseball exclusively on the show. Welcome back, and a new arm on the mound to start the eighth. Keegan Thompson.
And this could be a pretty critical point in this game. They're hoping he's the guy to keep him within striking distance.
Gavin Sheets steps to the plate for the White Sox. One for three.
Gavin Sheets.
Here comes a pitch. That misses. No. Ball one. And that drops in for a strike. That one ran inside, almost got him.
Clearly didn't come out of his hand the right way. Left that curveball way up.
Next offering is fouled back. The punch out there, and now one away. Leury Garcia steps to the plate for the White Sox. One's in there, 0-1.
No need to offer that pitch until you get to two strikes. It's just a low percentage of success when you want to try to go after that down and away pitch.
The 0-1. In the air, left field, down the line, and that drops foul. Right-handed reliever. That one missing inside.
0-2 curve right there. Hitter kind of expects that. And good job of just showing that confidence and trying to get back into this count.
Mm-hmm. Line drive, hauls it in for the out.
The bat, number one, shortstop, Elvis.
Elvis Andrews digs in now. In there for strike one. Next offering is outside.
One ball, one strike.
Smash to the left side. On to first, out number three. So they make short work of them there. Last half of the eighth coming up. It's the White Sox 5 and the Cubs 4. Back now, new pitcher on the mound as we roll into the bottom of the eighth, Joe Kelly.
Well, the best relievers love the opportunity to come in and protect a tight lead late in the ball game. Some of them are just wired different, so we'll see what he's got here.
The pitch. Up the middle, Garcia collects in plenty of time to first, and that is a big first out.
Well, such a confidence boost for a reliever to come into the ball game and get the first hitter he faces. Just makes everything slow down a little bit, and then from there can really settle in.
That one pushed foul, out of play off to the left. And the 0-1. Swing and a miss.
Bringing the cheese on that one.
Him looking. Clip the bottom of the zone with a curve for strike three.
Well, he's going to have some thinking to do when he leaves the ballpark after this one. That was his third strikeout, and this one looking, obviously, so he's been a little overmatched. He's got to find a way just to be more competitive up there at the plate.
Looks like it'll be a pinch hitter, Christopher Morel, trying to get something going for him with two away. And that's in there for strike one. The tying run at the plate.
1-1.
In the air, right field. A little bloop single. Joey gets on base and keeps it going.
Always feels amazing getting a job done when the team needs you to come through. It's just bigger than your own individual stats. When you pop a ball up like that, you don't expect it to get you a knock too often. But right there, somehow he got it to drop in behind first base, and that's where no one could get to it.
And now they've got some speed on first, so we'll see if they try to get him into motion.
Barnhart in the box here lets that one go for a ball. Swing and a miss, chased it out of the zone.
Right now they're looking for something, hit hard into the gaps, give them an opportunity with two outs to score that run from first.
So now 1-2. And now 2-2. That one misses, and the count is filled up.
3-2, two out, runner on first. A lot of movement in the infield. Hitter's got to stay focused on the pitch.
Morrell off of first with two away. Out towards left center. And Benintendi able to make the grab. And that is that. One left for the Cubs. Still down a run. It's 5-4. Staying in the game on defense, Christopher Morrell. He'll play third after coming into the game as a pinch hitter.
Now playing.
Well, one run game. Luis Robert steps to the plate for the White Sox. Thompson back to work. Thompson, in his second season, he features a four-seam fastball, a cutter, a curve, a changeup, and he works in a two-seamer. Kicks and fires. And a pop-up, right side, foul territory. Pulls it in on the run. And there's one down.
That was a good, hard fastball with some nice ride up in the zone right there. Hitter looked like he was on it, but I think that velocity at the end just beat him. Instead of a line drive or something hit deep, it's a pop-up and an easy out for the defense.
Benintendi, batting with one down, takes a strike.
Not sure if he was expecting for the pitcher to come right at him, but he got a nice cookie there and just watched it the entire way.
And that one is lifted in the air. Suzuki on the move. And there's two away.
Now back. The designated hitter.
Two outs, base is empty. Here's the White Sox DH, Eloy Jimenez. Outfield playing very deep, not wanting anything over their heads. And the first offering is not close.
Not looking like they'll be adding any insurance runs heading to the bottom of the ninth, so it's going to be on the bullpen to hold this lead.
Two down, nobody on. Late swing, fouled off. Next offering down in the dirt. Good eye in that spot.
This is a really good feeling for a hitter. At this point in the ball game, you know that they don't want to walk you, so you're going to get a pitch to hit. You just better not miss it.
3-2 now. Crowd locked in right now. One run game here in the ninth. Now this is in the air down the line. Suzuki racing over to make the catch. Nothing across here this half. To the bottom of the ninth we go. Top of the order, due up. It's the White Sox 5 and the Cubs 4. Now on the bump, Kendall Graveman. And this guy can bring it velocity-wise.
Your attention, please. Now pitching for the White Sox, number 39.
Back to the leadoff spot in the Cubs lineup. Now it's the second baseman, Nico Horner, known for his late inning heroics. The pitch.
It's good speed at the top of the order here. You want to get it on, see if you can get a stolen base, maybe get around the bases and pick up a run.
Looking to get the tying run on base. Check swing didn't go. And the count even, 1-1. And that one just missed off the outside edge.
The 2-1. Fouled off left side. And a 2-2. And that's outside. And a pitch. Foul off the plate. They'll do it again. At the belt and fires. Out to short. Andrews handles the chance. Not in time. An infield knock to start the inning.
Well, that's one of those where you just have to tip your cap because he couldn't have played that one any better. Stood no chance with the speed running down the line.
And next for the Cubs, Dansby Swanson. First offering misses badly for ball one. One missing low.
Really been able to slow down the game tonight with his at bats, and the biggest one he's had so far. He doesn't look anxious at all.
The 2-0 is in for a strike. Tying run at first, the winning run at the plate. Ground ball left side. Nice stop to second. There's one, and they turn a double play.
Well, that's a huge ball in play to get the double play defensively. Just one more guy to get this save for the closer.
Ian Happ, the next Cub to hit. That one back up the middle and it gets through.
Now back, right fielder.
Now the Cubs four-hole hitter, Seiya Suzuki.
And things could change quickly here with one swing. Typically, the outfield defense will play a little bit deeper just to keep the ball in front, make sure that runner on first doesn't come all the way around to score and tie this ball game up.
Pulls that one foul. Trying to keep the game alive here in the bottom of the ninth. Oh, right to the backstop.
As a closer, he's out there in that role for a reason, but even they lose the handle on one here and there, especially with all the nasty stuff coming out of bullpens these days. He's making it a little interesting here.
Man on second, two down. High ground ball for a base knock. Happ on his way home. He scores to tie it up. 5-5 now.
Huge moment for him and his team, Boog. You know, some guys just grip it a bit too tight in a big spot like this, having a chance to tie it up in the bottom of the ninth. But he didn't let the moment get to him. Comes up with the RBI knock, and now he's giving his teammates a chance to walk this thing off with a win if they can push across another run.
So two down, Eric Hosmer getting ready to hit. First pitch, and that's in for a strike.
and he deals. Sets him down looking. A controversial called strike three to end the inning. But the RBI single pushes across a run. All even at five apiece. On to extra innings. Here's the third baseman, Yoan Moncada. And a pitch.
Well, it's kind of deflating. You blow that lead in the bottom of the ninth. So here's a new opportunity. Hit the reset button. Try to get some more runs and then close it out in the bottom half of this one.
And a pitch. And now 2-0. Movement in the bullpen. Nick Avila, the rookie right-hander, is getting loose. Bummer, the power lefty, up as well. Swing and a high fly ball to left. Pat makes the play. One up, one down.
Now back to first baseman, Andrew Vaughn.
Andrew Vaughn steps to the plate for the White Sox.
Well, first base open. Really no reason to pitch to this hitter right here. Put him on. Have the force at second, first. Perhaps getting inning-ending double play.
In there, and it's 0-1.
Come on, one strike.
One out. The go-ahead run is at second. Next pitch is downstairs. And it's fouled away. The pitch. Fights that one away. Still 1-2. Right-hander kicks, deals. Tap back to the mound. He caught it behind his back. And that's a great play for the out.
Well, there's a lot riding on that at bat right there. Nice job of the pitcher to bear down, make the pitch, get the ground ball. Excellent piece of work.
Pinch hitter coming on, Sebi Zavala. A critical at bat in this game for him.
Sebi Zavala.
That fastball drilled him.
Now that can happen when you're trying to dive out over the plate so you can control the outer half. Very difficult to get out of the way of good velocity in.
In the air, left field. Half raging back towards the wall. Pulls it in on the warning track. Two left on to the bottom of inning number 10. We're all tied up 5-5. So remaining in the game defensively, Sebi Zavala. He takes over behind the plate to do the catching after entering the game as a pitcher. Back here at the ballpark, ready to go for the last half of the inning. And here's the DH for the Cubs, Trey Mancini.
Oh, how he'd love to walk it off right here.
The pitch out to short, goes to third for one, but no throw to first as he'll hold on to it. And up to the plate comes Cody Bellinger. Pitch misses inside, and that's ball one. Meanwhile,
Activity in the bullpen. Nick Avila appears to be getting ready, and I'm sure he's feeling some nerves. This would be his major league debut. Bummer, a lefty warming up as well. Next one misses. Two balls, no strikes to count. One down, winning run on at first. He swings and hits a fly ball, center field, way back there. And caught on the warning track.
Man, he hammered that one to center. I thought it was out of here, but Wynn just absolutely killed it.
Now the third baseman, Christopher Morel. And he's already singled in this game. High fly ball, right field. Sheets drifts towards it. Makes the grab, and that'll end the inning. So no runs, no hits, no errors, and one left. We push on to the 11th. We're all tied up 5-5. Here's a new pitcher from the pen, Rowan Wick. And he has some nasty breaking stuff. Go ahead, run on base. Leury Garcia now at the plate.
Look for him to hit behind the runner, perhaps shoot it to the right side.
The pitch. And that one off the outside edge. And a foul ball. Gonna count 1-2.
Clearly was sitting on a fastball right there and just ended up out in front of the slider. Hey, you can't fault him for his commitment. Now he's just gonna have to battle with two strikes.
And a pitch. And a ground ball to first. And he takes it himself for the out.
Now back
to the top of the White Sox lineup. Stepping in, the White Sox leadoff man, Elvis Andrus. That hits the dirt, and that is ball one. Righty to the plate. That one misses. Two balls, no strikes. Ball tied up. We are in the 11th. Next pitch, not close, up high. See if he gives him anything to hit here. And fires in a fastball at 95. And that one lifted in the air center field. Bellinger sizing it up. Racing makes the catch. Two away down.
Up next to the White Sox, the center fielder, Luis Robert.
And now the center fielder, Luis Robert. First pitch, not close. Two down, go ahead, run at scoring position. On the ground, right side. Hosmer takes it to the bag, third out. The White Sox leave one, and this remains a 5-5 ball game. Nick Avila on a pitch here.
Number 13, Nick Avila.
Runner in scoring position, no outs. Now the Cubs catcher, Tucker Barnhart. And the pitch. Foul ball there. And the right-hander deals. Pitch misses. And now it's even, 1-1. Kicks and deals. And he flips a breaking ball in there, or a changeup.
Either one. Something off speed. Good arm action on it. Whatever it was.
Next offering is downstairs. And now the count filled up 3-2. This to third. Zips it across. One up, one down.
Up next is the second baseman.
And stepping in is the speedy Nico Horner.
Listen, there's absolutely no reason to pitch to this guy right here. You nibble, you see if he'll expand his zone, but don't give him anything to hit. If you walk him, not a big deal. You have a double play opportunity set up.
Swing and a ball lifted to center field. Nice grab on the run. And there's two down. Dansby Swanson, the next cup to hit. That one's in there, 0-1.
And I know you want to be patient as a hitter, but you got to be ready to jump on the first thing straight. And he got one right there, but left the bat on his shoulder.
Ripped on the ground a second, in time to ball. And the Cubs go 1-2-3. Cubs leave one. Our score holds at 5 apiece. Welcome back. Benintendi to start it. Wick back to work. Tried to check his swing. Appeal to third. And yes, he did. He went around. Fouled off. He was late. Pulled out on strikes. Not sure about that call. Pitcher might have gotten a friendly strike three.
Well, big strikeout right there, and maybe a little controversial with the call. I think he got a little bit of favor on the mound. No question about it. It's not exactly what you want to see in a big spot like that, and I'm sure there's some chirping going on from the dugout, making it clear that wasn't his best call behind the plate today.
Now it's going to be Eloy Jimenez. And the first pitch misses for ball one. Robert, the runner at second with one away. Swing and a miss. And that is strike one.
Man, he was really tardy on that fastball. Great job of setting him up by throwing the curveball. Add some velocity to it on the next pitch. Can't catch up.
The 1-1 is upstairs. And it's 2-1. That one missed.
Get ready for some action here. Good RBI guy at the plate. Runners in scoring position. And a hitter's count.
Okay. Swing and a miss. 3-2 now.
I think he was sitting off speed there.
On the ground to third. Morrell handles. Fires across the diamond. And they take care of Jimenez for the out.
Good late bite on that slider. Got the hitter out in front. Rolled over on it. Exactly what it was supposed to do.
Here is Yoan Moncada. First pitch doesn't find the zone. And the righty deals. Pitch misses. Ball two. Righty delivers. Swing and a miss. Strike one.
Instead of letting the hitter get his arms extended, tied him up a little bit. Slightly up, slightly in.
Lined into right. Suzuki makes the grab. And that is the third out of the inning. So a man left for the White Sox. This ball game still tied 5-5. Back here in Wrigley Field, here's the left fielder, Ian Happ. And here it comes. That catches the corner. Bullpen activity starting up now. Aaron Bummer up and throwing. Man at second. Late with the swing there. Bounced up the middle. Andrews over to pick it up. And that is a big first out.
Now batter, the right fielder.
And next will be the cleanup hitter, Seiya Suzuki.
So he came up clutch earlier in this ball game and really just needs to take the same approach. Think hard right back up the middle.
That one lifted to left. Benintendi is there. Snags it for the second out.
Just pulled off of it a little bit right there. That front shoulder coming open instead of staying closed. If he does that, he's going to be able to go up the middle the other way with some authority instead of a fly out to left.
And next for the Cubs, Eric Hosmer. And the first offering is not close. And this is inside.
Not showing great command so far in this at bat. 2-0 count. He's got to execute here or this could get ugly.
Next offering is in for a strike. Thank you. And there's a ball. Left-hand hitter waits. Popped up. And it falls. In comes the winning run, and the Cubs win it in 12.
You know, he had to feel the pressure. Winning run on second base. Found a way to make solid contact, and the winning run comes across to score. Everyone going crazy. Exciting finish to this game today.
Six-five, the final here today. The Cubs go home a winner. For Chris Singleton and our entire outstanding crew here at MLB The Show, I'm John Ciambi. Thanks for joining us.
Here now is our final line score this afternoon. First for the victorious Chicago Cubs. 6 runs on 13 hits. No errors. They left 12 men on base.